formatting a drive on a Mac is very easy. I'm just at the Mac desktop. This applies to the version of the operating system that I'm currently in, Mojave, but this also applies to Catalina, High Sierra, Sierra, any of the Mac OSs. This process is going to be very similar. Go to the Go menu at the top of the screen in the upper left corner and go down to the Utilities folder, and that will open up the Utilities folder. Inside there, you're looking for the disk utility. This is a piece of software that comes with the Mac operating system. And it will allow you to format a drive. Now, you have to be very careful with this, because when you format, and another term for that would be to partition it or erase it, you're wiping out all the data on the drive. So if you're going to partition, erase, or format, or initialize any one of those terms, you want to be sure that you have all of the data backed up from that drive to another location, if you care about it. If it's old stuff that you're not worried about, then don't worry about it. When you do this process to a drive, all of the information on the drive will be lost unless you've backed it up to another drive somewhere else previously. So be careful. And you also want to be careful that when you do this process that you are actually formatting or erasing or partitioning the actual drive that you want to do. So in any example that I tend to do this, I will often remove by unmounting a drive. So if I wanted to unmount a drive, I can just select it, right click on it, and choose eject, and that will remove it from the desktop. And then it will also allow me to disconnect it if it's an external drive. Not a bad idea. Just be careful that you don't format or initialize the wrong drive. Okay, let me get this folder out of here. All right, so in this case, I'm going to look at this little thumb drive that I have connected here, and your view may look a little bit different, so I'm going to show only volumes. This is probably the view that you will most likely see when you're using Disk Utility in Mojave or Catalina. It's going to show you the drives as they appear on your desktop. They're referred to as volumes. So I've got 4TB 1, 4TB 2. That's what these drives are over here. There's 4TB 2, 4TB 1. That's how they appear on the desktop, right? So if I go to the upper left corner of the Disk Utility and show all devices, it not only shows me the, for example, for 4TB, the volume as it appears on the desktop of my Mac, but it also shows me the actual, you know, hard drive mechanism. It's a Toshiba drive, and it will give me information about that drive and how it's formatted, and that's what we want to do to this new drive here. So I'm going to select this drive down here at the bottom. It is currently looks like it's a 32GB thumb drive, and I've got it selected. I've verified that this is the drive that I want to format, and I'm being very careful here. And up at the top, if it's a brand new drive, I'll just do erase. And I will do this process on any brand new drive that I add to my system. Because remember, when you purchase a new drive, the drive manufacturer doesn't necessarily know if you're going to install it on a Mac or a PC. So they often come in this kind of a generic format that will launch or mount or operate on either a Mac or a Windows machine, which is good, but that format is not optimized for a Mac or a Windows machine. So you want to do this process so that you are making sure that the format of the new drive that you're adding to your system is the proper format. So for Mac, it's Mac OS Extended Journaled, and the scheme is GUID Partition Map. And now let me go back and get to this. So I've selected the actual drive mechanism that I want to erase, and up at the top of the Disk Utility, I click on Erase. And I can name it whatever I want, audio drive, Pro Tools drive, external drive, doesn't matter. Keep it kind of short though. And the format, you have several different options here. We do not want to use MS-DOS or XFAT for a Mac drive. We want to use Mac OS Extended Journaled. Do not use encrypted, use Mac OS Extended Journaled. and the scheme, if it's available in this pop-up menu, is GUID partition map, right? That's what we want for this drive. And then you click erase, and the process will take maybe 30 seconds, 60 seconds or top, the drive tops. The drive will unmount from your desktop, so you will see it disappear, and it will go through this process, and then it will mount again. And when the drive comes back up, oftentimes you will see a dialog saying something about, do you want to use this drive for Time Machine? No, we do not want to use this newly erased drive for Time Machine. That's a whole nother conversation. So once that's done, you're good to go. You can go in there and create folders if you want. You can record to it. You can play back from it. And that's the process for a Mac. This is how you format a drive in Windows 10. Go to the Start menu, right-click on it, and choose Disk Management. The Disk Management window will open up. Select the drive that you want to format, right-click, choose Format, and then name it. I chose to name this one called Audio Drive. I chose to name this one Audio Drive. You can name it whatever you want. And the file system that we want is NTFS. You can use the allocation unit size set to default. That's fine. Click OK. Formatting this drive will erase all data. Yes, remember, if there's anything on the drive, that you, be sure to back it up, copy it off. And the formatting process will take 60 seconds or so. Or longer. Okay, once it's done, the drive will be listed in the disk management as a healthy disk. I'll go to this PC, formerly known as this computer. Thank you, Windows, for changing things and moving things around to unintuitive locations. There's my audio drive. It's drive D. And I'll check the properties. It is a NTFS drive, perfect for recording with Pro Tools.